So this is a quick little motivational video. As you could see, this is like the second time ever that I've ever been on camera and ready. I'm about to leave. I had a couple minutes, but I wanted to thank video a couple things on here, and then one issue that I've addressed before that I really just want to hit again. I want to thank everybody that's been posting on my page. People that aren't clients of mine that have just been following me. A friend of mine that I posted her article on my Facebook, that she wrote an article about negativity and pain, and she talked about me in the article. And then another friend of mine that posted her pictures and made mention about me. And all I do is post motivational pictures every morning at 5:30 because that's what I committed to doing. And then my picture just to show, and this is what I comment on everything, that when people thank me for motivation, I say, I really am nothing without you guys. I need you just as much as you might comment that you need me and my motivation. If it wasn't for Facebook and me having, I'm a woman of my word, and the four agreements, I swear by it. So because I gave you guys my word that I would motivate you, that's what gets me up in the morning. I have to be a woman of my word. I have to post my motivational picture. I have to. That's, I get up at 4 o'clock in the morning on purpose because I want to be the first thing that people read when they wake up in the morning. Cause it's almost like my clients, that's what I mean. Like my clients that I'm at 4 o'clock in the morning, I'm responding to clients' food logs. So I designed that schedule for myself because I want to be up earlier than you guys so that I'm the first thing that you're reading. Granted, there are some people that are across the country or in other countries that if they're across the country and I'm waking up at 4 o'clock and responding to their log, that's their 7. And some of them might beat me and might be up earlier than me, but that's why I started that. Plus it gets me in the morning, gets me to, you know, give you positive feedback no matter what your log look like, which we all make mistakes, and most of the logs, almost every log is great. There are a few mistakes and critiques, which I make, but ultimately everyone starts with a positive feedback and ends with positive feedback. Praise, correct praise, PCP, that's what I talk about. No matter what the food log look like. I need to say those positive things and they need to see that every morning. That's my way of kind of like forcing them to do their positive affirmations, which I've talked about in my videos. I need to get up at that time and then I'm up already. So then I do my cardio and then I admit it to you guys, no matter how tired I am, even if I'm answering food logs like this with one eye open, like totally done before, I still get up and have to get on the treadmill because people are looking forward to seeing that I get up and I do this every day. I don't compete. I do this. I like when people ask me, what are you training for? My health, my son, my family, my clients. That's what it's all about. Yes, I have competed before. I don't do it anymore. I originally did it just to show women that you can have Crohn's disease, have a hypothyroid, have fasciitis in your feet, have issues with your hamstrings, tendonitis, bursitis, all the issues that I have, and I could still get into good shape even, and having a baby, and still get into good shape. So that's the only reason why I did it. I did well with them. I kept going. I was on like a little competition high for a year, and then that's it. Like that's not what I want to do. I want to help people that are emotionally connected to food, all that other stuff. But this video is also about a gentleman that has a fan page, I believe. And I can't remember how the whole process went through, but apparently somebody tagged me, in a picture that he did. The picture that got so much negative feedback that it's ridiculous and it's so sad for me to even talk about that, of me and my son. But he, somebody tagged me in it, and then he actually sent me a private message and then friend requested me. I think he put it up on his fan page. His name is David the Beast, all one word. David the Beast, all one word. Douglas. He is a friend of mine, so you can look through, and he will be reposting that picture. And so basically, why I'm thanking him is because I appreciate who he is and what he's doing. He has a page and it's all about positive feedback, all about women and I think it's called Ladies Beast something. And I totally apologize. This is a last minute video that I decided to do, but I want you to go to him and then find out where the heck it is. Because one of the things that he commented is that he will not allow any negative comments. If there's one on there, it's just because he's not home. And as soon as he gets home, he erases them. And I love that because I am human. And no matter what, I do have feelings. And we all know the couple things that I've been going... Well, I go through it every day. But what I've been posting, what I posted a couple last week about the woman on fan page, and then all the negative comments that I get on YouTube. But to have somebody that has a fan page for the right reasons and doesn't allow the negativity, thank you. So to repost my picture, and then if anybody says anything negative, to take it down, I appreciate that. Because I will be honest with you, the picture of me and my son had a head and he had feet. He's actually wearing his car's slippers from Christmas. And the original person that edited that picture and cut my head off stated that they cut my head off for a reason. They say that when you take the person's face and eyes out of the picture, it draws more, like, I guess, controversial or whatever. People tend to lean more towards negative and positive. And this specific person wanted to get more of both sides, which I don't care if you see this video, but kind of shame on you for even wanting somebody to post anything negative about it and editing my picture just for your, just to get more people to comment on your picture, because you were taking somebody else's life and just posting it and then asking people to negatively comment by admitting that you cut my head off for that reason. So, that being said, and then the one issue that I do want to address that I have addressed before is totally off the subject of that. And it just has to do, it has to do with negativity, but it has to do with negativity from family members, which in that article that that person wrote on my Facebook that I posted, she does talk about family, and that's the hardest thing. And I did have another, client of mine that expressed some issues yesterday with family and feeling down, and you can't eliminate them like you can a Facebook friend or even a high school friend that you're just not close with anymore because you guys don't see eye to eye on the same things or you've grown apart. You do have to stay busy. You do have to avoid them. You do have to learn how to deal with them different because you're never going to change them. Just like back in the day, like, I don't really talk to my dad as much. Hardly. I've accepted him and I've forgiven him for everything that I went through in the past. But I've learned, I tried to change him when I was younger. I tried to get him to see my way. I wrote him letters and then I started writing in a journal to him and never actually let him see it. And I would just speak about my issue with him, but never let him see it because that was my issue. And then I learned how to deal with him differently. And now it's like he's in a distance. I haven't seen him in a really long time. I think he's only met my son once or twice. But again, I don't live with the fact that I'm mad at him because then I'll never really be free of my issues. But that's how I deal with him. Some of you that have to live close to a family member that you don't get along with, kind of like how it was with me and him, you just have to try to stay busy and try to talk to the family members that are positive, bring over games, try to avoid conversations with the negative person. And then, you know, maybe try to like be more busy. You can't do the things like if you have every Sunday, but then sometimes it's in the middle of the week, don't go over in the middle of the week. Just mentally prepare yourself for every Sunday. So I hope that this video helped because negativity is terrible. It will crush dreams. And I don't mean to sound cheesy, but it will. And every one of your dreams can be a reality if you believe it. So that being said, thank you to David and the Beast. And thank you to the people that posted on my Facebook. And thank you to the woman that wrote the article. And it's all on my Facebook. It's all on my profile page. You guys can all go see it. And I love you all. Oh, if you're not my friend on Facebook, you need to be my friend. So Jennifer Russo Aguirre, JennIfeRRussoAguirre. Do you like that?